They say timing is everything and every vote counts.
So whether Albuquerque voters will see the issue of abortion on their election ballot depends on how fast 20,000 signatures are verified. Action 7's reporter Laura Train is live to explain.
And the city clerk's office tells me that they are spending every minute going over all of those signatures. Even still, this issue could cost taxpayers $600,000. Despite that cost, this could be the very best outcome for Mayor Barry. Political experts say it could help him get reelected. Mayor Barry says as a citizen, he would vote against late-term abortion.
I've said publicly that I'm opposed to late-term abortion and I'll vote accordingly.
His view is shared by roughly 20,000 other voters in Bernalillo County who are trying to get the ban on late-term abortions on the ballot. But before that can happen, all those signatures have to be counted.
I'm coming in early, I'm staying late, I'm not taking lunches so we can get the work done.
City Clerk Amy Bailey says if those signatures are not tallied and verified by early September, this abortion initiative wouldn't be on the ballot the same day as the mayoral election. It would go to special election. The cost of that
is around $600,000.
KOAT political analyst Brian Sanderoff says because the mayor is the front runner, it's in his best interest for this issue to not be on the ballot October 8th.
Usually the candidate who's ahead in the polls wants to avoid any surprises or unknowns. And of course, this abortion initiative would be an unknown.
Mayor Barry says since he has no control over when the signatures will be counted, he's not losing any sleep over the issue.
I mean, it's just going to be on one of the elections. It'll either be on the October 8th or it'll be later than that. And it'll be really out of our hands and it'll be when it is.
And I spoke to the other candidates for mayor. Paul Hayes says that he hopes that this initiative is on the ballot on the 8th, that way that more people will show up. Pete Dinelli didn't have any comment as far as when it will be on the ballot. He just said he is opposed to the initiative. That's the very latest from downtown Albuquerque. Laura Terrain, KOAT Action 7 News.
The city clerk's office says about 30% of signatures are rejected, either because the person doesn't live in Bernalillo County or the handwriting is illegible.